Greetings from Knoxville, Tennessee. It is Sunday, the 15th of January, 2023. I'll try to keep this short and simple. I found this wine cooler on Marketplace for $40 and gutted it. That is where the compressor and wires and tubes were. Cleaned it out, threw some heat tape in. You know the drill if you've been looking at these. And now I'm doing a test run. Decided to go with the Inkbird because I haven't used one before and it gets really good reviews. It's an on-off thermostat. So if it does the job, excellent. I'm not worried about 5 degree fluctuation here and there with snake eggs because in the wild, they're not a constant temperature. Sorry, I lost my train of thought. This is just a little command module I made. This is the fan that's inside, the computer fan. It's a USB drive for power, so found this cool little thing on Amazon. Of course, this is where the heat tape is plugged in, and that goes to the thermostat. And back here, the hole I had to drill, what I did there was I took some polyfill, and there it is right there. That's for making stuffed animals, pillows, whatnot. We keep it on hand for when our dogs tear up a stuffed animal. So I put tape back here, and then from the inside, I stuffed some polyfill, and then put duct tape again. Let me see if I can grab a flashlight and show you that. I didn't want to use silicone or something like that because I wanted to be able to change things if I needed to. So there you go, right up there is where all the cords go. There's my computer fan. And those are the extra shelves that go in here. But I am really happy with this. I'm thinking if you were to buy an incubator that will hold as many eggs as this will, by the way, there's my soon to be egg bins. I can fit 2 per shelf and I think I fit 3 shelves in there. So that's 6 of those. That's gonna be plenty for what I need. Eventually I will put some water bottles down there as a heat sink. But I think an incubator this big, anywhere from $500 to $1,000. Total in this, I may have $100. I already had the heat tape on hand, so I didn't have to buy that. And it warmed up really quickly in there. So I'm gonna open up the door real fast. Of course, that's going to change the temperature. And let's just see what's going on in here. So right at, there's 79, which is what it's showing. Down on the floor there, 76. Up on the ceiling, 78. And remember, when I opened the door, the heat just went up and out. So it's going to be more stable down there when the door's closed and I have those water bottles in. I got to tell you, I'm impressed with this Inkbird so far. Of course, before I put eggs in, I will let that run for a couple of weeks just to be sure. And I'll throw some photos up here at the end of just some pictures I took as I was doing this, and that's it. My second ever DIY incubator. This is just a whole lot nicer than the first one I did. Thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully we'll have another set of black milk snake eggs, another clutch here in, a couple of months. So thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.